everybody, welcome back to my channel.
Yeah, I know that's not how these videos start. If you guys are new to the channel, what's going on? Not the real Will Smith and another for your mother. Look, hey, we're out here with Dorianne right now. We went to Buffalo Wild Wings. We had our workout kind of got changed, and I'm just doing a little vlog here with her because we have an aspiring YouTuber. Well, she wants to be a YouTuber, and we're going to make it happen. Ooh. Tell them about yourself. The viewers want to know. How are you? So she talks and video bombs the video in the beginning and then doesn't talk when the camera's on her. She's just gonna laugh her life away.
Okay.
You good now?
What?
She not good. But anyways, I'ma talk because you not. So y'all know from the last video I made, when I made guacamole and we had a story time, this ain't it. Like,
it's given processed.
It's giving processed vibes, fake vibes. We don't do fake here.
You can't say that and then eat it. Just ate it like it's nothing. You talking about we don't do fake here. God must still eat it though.
It's gone.
It doesn't taste that bad.
I don't like tomatoes either, y'all, by the way. So, no. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah. So I don't think I've done a lot of like daily vlogs and story times, car talks and car shows, car meets, challenges. But I don't think I ever did a video sitting down eating food with someone else.
We could do a mukbang one day.
This is a mukbang now. Thank you. Look at you. What are we going to talk about? Woo! First of all, I need y'all to understand. Look at that light. Look at those edges.
No Gorilla Glue. Gorilla Glue where?
Not she said, all. She said, this ain't a wig. That's what she said. I ain't putting nobody out there. I'm just saying. She said it's all natural.
What do you know about like new religion? Ooh. Have you heard about that?
The new religion.
That's okay.
No, I have. Yeah, not. Don't just get distracted. I have not heard about new religion. We were talking about Christianity earlier.
Okay.
No, we were talking about Christianity earlier. They didn't hear our conversation. So you tell me about, you said the new religion.
Mm-hmm.
So tell me about it. Do you want the chicken over here?
Yeah, we
right I'll just move this over here. Oh yeah, real quick guys, you guys can see our food. So I got honey barbecue and she got Parmesan.
Garlic.
Parmesan. And you know, blue cheese is king. So we only gonna eat the blue cheese. And
blue cheese is what?
It's the best. We're gonna throw the ranch out.
Oh, okay.
Blue cheese is the best one for the ranch out. That's what we said. See? She agreed. But, no, tell me. So, new religion.
So, basically, they're trying to, like, come up with, like, a new religion. And it has to do with, like, manifestation. It has to do with, like, basically witchcraft.
So,
and energy and horoscopes and believing in the universe. Believing in the universe. So it has to do a lot with like what's that word? Yeah, I'm remembering the word right now. Not physics. Oh, something about physics.
Science?
Yeah. It has to do with like believing in physics or something like that. Basically like believing in the world. And it's like opposing Christianity, but it's also trying to like downplay Christianity at the same time because they're saying that Christians also believe in that new religion. but it's not really like that. I don't know. It's like, I think it's like what they're doing nowadays to like try to get people's view, like people's view on Jesus or Christianity to be like twisted. You know what I mean? To be twisted into like pull away from or, you know.
And I'm glad you said that because I was just about to say that the society that we live in now, like with the new generation, a lot of things have changed and people try to misconstrue what's being taught versus what's going on in reality right now.
Mm-hmm.
And try to mesh the two together, which could be a new religion, right? That could be considered a new religion. So definitely understand. But also I think my issue with new religion is, based on what you're saying, it sounds like it's a lot of hypocrisy out there in the world, and saying one thing but doing another. And when you say things and it just doesn't make sense to me, I'm a zone out. Honestly, that's just me personally. I'm like, you're saying this, but this is what's going on. Yeah, not saying for you, but I'm just saying in general. Like, you'll know someone that's like, hey, this is an old school Christian here. They have their values and beliefs, and it's like, hey, these are values and beliefs that we've learned growing up. And then you have someone in a new generation that say, hey, you have to fill your partner out. Let's say, for example, it's okay to have sex before marriage, and you know, you need this. This is what people are saying, you know?
But you can't.
You can't. You need the commandments. But people will misconstrue the word. So, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know, that's just, I guess, on my mind a little bit, because, I don't know, I just feel like this world, believe it or not, needs so much healing, and in order for the world to heal, it has to be done correctly, it has to be done with a reliable source, or something genuine, something that can sustain the amount of healing that needs to be done, and I just...
What do you think would be that level for the direction that the world is going in? What level of healing? More direct answer. What do you think will change the dynamic of what? What do you think will change the dynamic of the new world religion? I don't think it's ever going to go away. But how do you think that people can get back to understanding original Christianity? For example, we're not trying to just generalize like it's just Christianity and nothing else, because there's people that believe and there's other, like Muslims and Jewish, you know? So, aren't Jews Christian?
Huh?
Aren't Jews Christian?
Jews Christian? Jews see things totally different.
Oh, okay. But
so it's different.
But yeah, for the purpose of this video, we're just talking about...
Yes, it's good.
Thank you so much. We're just talking about Christianity, but I know that YouTube is a multi, you know, diverse community, religion or not. So whatever your views or beliefs, I'm not trying to change it. We're just having a conversation solely.
Yeah, this is just something I guess that's on my mind. And
I want to say this because I know I'm going to get some comments on this channel and they were like, you know, and I don't want to cause no beef. I love everyone. So, yeah. Side note. This is the second video with the new iPhone. If you guys notice, and this is the front camera. Look how good the front camera looks. Like, stop it. Yeah. I need a shave. But I have a haircut.
I'm gonna eat one of your wings.
What are you doing?
I'm gonna eat a wing of yours. It's okay. Sharing is caring.
I did share it with you.
Alright, you know what? You can keep it back.
I just want to see what her heart was. Yeah. Look at her. She got about to get spicy.
I'll give it back.
She's like, you can have it. So I was sitting over here because it's actually a basketball game on Boston versus Miami. We in the playoffs. And I told them that Boston was going to win. Boston's up 127. Miami has 99. and it's a minute 25 left. Come on. Miss Boston.
Yes.
She took my seat.
I didn't answer your question.
What didn't answer my question?
I did. Huh? You asked me a question about, like, what do I think
of the new religion?
You basically, you also asked me, like, what do you think, what's it called? To help, like, the people who know about the new religion but want to know, like, about Jesus or something like that.
Right.
Like, what do you think the level of healing, yeah, what it would take for that level of healing to basically be, for it to succeed, basically.
Right.
So, I think it will have to do with, like, really digging deep and choosing to want to learn about Jesus. That's Jesus. I don't know what other Jesus you've ever heard of, but, like, Jesus Christ, the one that you read about in the Bible, whether it's the New King James Version or NIV, or which other Bible I guess you prefer. Pero I think it's wanting to really know about it because
she said, but sorry.
Yeah, pero is but in Spanish. I think it would have to take that, like, wanting, people would have to take that leap of faith to want to seek the real Jesus and not the watered down or
misconstrued,
exactly, twisted version of him. Because,
but when you say people need to take that leap of faith, that's still not answering the question of what will it take for them to take that leap of faith. You know what I'm saying? What do you think it will take for them to be like, hey, boom?
I mean, it could take prayer. You know, like, people could pray about it. Mm-hmm. You know, people could definitely, like, it could be a group thing where a lot of people can intercede for the people who are going down the path of new religion. That could, you know, that could assist in that. But also, it's an individual choice, because salvation is your individual choice. In terms of,
so when you say salvation, is it internal, like, or external?
Internal, like,
okay,
everyone's in charge of their own salvation is what I'm saying. So you're in charge of the faith that you have, or who you serve, or whatever the case may be. You choose what path you want to go down. So, which is why I say people have to seek, they themselves have to seek the real Jesus, not the watered down, not the misconstrued or the twisted version of him, but the real Jesus. So I think prayer and people really seeking and just like having that thirst and that hunger for righteousness is what would open the door to the path of healing for a lot of people. Because I don't know. I guess my beliefs, I don't think healing can, the man of the world needs it. I'm not talking about, like, just a specific group, like, new religion people, but I think the world completely, the way the world entirely needs it, it's on a very large scale. And that's not something that can be done, like, incorrectly or by ourselves or anything. We need divine intervention at this point. That's just, I guess, my
I'm glad. That's a great way to end it. Divine intervention. She'd be a proctor somewhere, you know? Like, motivational speaker.
I just, you know, that's what I see it like. That's how I think about it. And if we need divine intervention, it has to be the correct one.
Okay.
You know, like, in terms of the living God, not demons. Because basically that's what New Age is. You're embracing demons. You're embracing the sinful life. That's what you're embracing.
Mm-hmm.
You're embracing the fact that you want to turn your eye from Jesus Christ and his father. It all becomes your choice, like I said. Because whenever you pass away, it's not gonna be me, it's not gonna be you, but whoever passes away is gonna have to face Jesus. And he's gonna, I'm sure he'll probably ask for some things or however he handles that, but at the end, it'll be a choice that you made. It'll be a choice of what you did with your time. Did you try to seek him? What did you do to seek him? How did you fulfill the plan that he had for you? Did you even fulfill it at all? Whatever the case may be. So, like I said, people have to make that choice.
Okay. You're preaching to me. So Dorianne teaches me something new every day. You shouldn't steal though.
No. I'm borrowing.
So pick up the fidget spinner. So there, you guys know I'm active duty, back in the military again after my break in service. And it's a fidget spinner over there, the little black one. She's about to spin it. Yeah. And I named it Clifford Jr. because the truck's name is Clifford. She took it and said, I'm borrowing it. Then she gave it back to me and said, you can hold on to it, but I'm taking it back at dinner. So, it's not your world. It's Clifford Jr.'s world. And he wants to be with me. But then Dorianne does this thing. She does this reverse psychology stuff. And I'm like, okay, here you go. Not like manipulative, no, just jokingly. Like, I'd be like, why are you on this side of the chair? And she'll be like, well, I'll just go on the other side. And I'm like, no, you don't gotta go. And then she'll just smile. She'll just like, all right, okay.
Because it's like, those type of comments is like, almost like you're trying to imply something. And because I'm not gonna assume what you're trying to imply, I'm just gonna make a choice. Do you wanna stay here, or should I just go over there?
There you go, direct. Look at the spiciness. And this is why.
This is my way. I'm like, he tried to give it back to me. So I don't want to hear, oh, she took it. Look. And I had it on this side. Why? Because he gave it to me. And I didn't even ask him. Did I ask you? Yeah, look.
I can't talk with food in my mouth.
Oh, you had no food in your mouth.
Are you choking on?
Oh my gosh, my lemonade. My goodness.
You really gotta swallow before you choke.
Oh my gosh, it almost went up my nose. You really try to force somebody to where I can't speak when I got food in my mouth. You had nothing in your mouth.
Mm-hmm.
You guys.
Lord. I'm getting full. So, yeah, Dorianne took us out to dinner tonight. We're going out tomorrow night on me. And I told her, I said, I didn't want to spend money two nights in a row. That's not like me to do that anyway, especially during the week. She's like, I'll do it, you know? Because we went out, we worked out. We had a very good workout week. Very good. And I think she's making great progress. And I am too, because she's holding me accountable. So, like, this is the most in a row I've been in the gym consistently, including breaks. Like, you have to have a day off.
And we're only going up from here.
Mm-hmm.
We're only going up from here.
She doesn't know how to count, though. So don't let her count your reps when you're doing workouts.
Oh, man.
Yeah. She struggles a little bit. But other than
don't
that,
tell it's... my business.
She said, don't tell me. Oops.
No, I'm taking another one.
I'm gonna talk to you on the side. Come. I get barbecue. She said, oh, I like barbecue too. She only likes what I like. And she has the same sneakers I have. Okay. I listen to truth. That's why that chicken went in my mouth wrong.
Why are you lying?
I take it back.
Why are you lying?
I take it back. It's not the truth. You made me feel all bad and stuff, like, dang. You know? But
tell these people the truth. They want to know the truth.
The truth is,
you should not be speaking with food in your mouth. Like you said, right? I know. No, I can't. I can't take it seriously.
You never take me serious. We had a serious conversation. She laughs at me. I get all up. Chest all high like this. You know? Do y'all remember Donnie from the Wild Thornberries? And that is Donnie. People laughing at me. But
they're gonna think you're drunk or something.
Right, drunk off this lemonade. YouTube knows how I am. This is how I am all the time. But anyways, like I said, me and Dorianne, we had a great workout week for real. And you have to celebrate your success, your little milestones, and you know, it's just something small. Plus, she offered, you know, I'm not going to tell her no, but look at her. I do tell her no. No, I don't. I just won't say nothing. Yeah. So, she's a good person. And, yeah. Hmm. This is my little kid.
Hi.
How are you?
I wish I had to see how tired. Many. No, she's trying to distract. Do y'all see how many I have the red chickens? I mean,
the red chicken.
The barbecue chicken. And it do you see how good. Many of hers she has and how many of mine's? She says she didn't want barbecue chicken.
The thing about it is, like, I'm not trying to cut you off, but it's like, when I see you need help, I'm gonna just step in.
Who is she trying with that?
You're not asking for help, but it's like you're not really eating. So it's like, I think you're like trying to tell me you need help. So you don't even have to ask for it. Look, I don't even offer. I just go ahead and step in. Look at that.
She was reaching with that comment. Yeah, I heard her. I don't know. She must have got me confused with little Pablo that was walking over there earlier. You know, the little boy.
You need help with your food?
Okay, Charles.
Oh, no. Oh, no. We gonna cut that out. Y'all ain't hear that, right? Celtics, 127-102. I'm not even a Celtics fan, but I knew they was gonna win. I'm just that good. Yeah, appreciate you guys sticking around. I'm actually about to hang up on you guys. That sounds crazy. We're actually about to leave, y'all. I gotta hopefully edit this video. Today is actually Thursday. I can edit this video posted on Saturday. See, I got something to look at. And if you guys are new to the channel and you haven't checked out the previous video, I made a video on how to buy an easy pass, how to set it up for your vehicle, especially if you have out-of-state tags, there's certain procedures you have to go through if you are in the state of New York, New Jersey, or whatever the case may be, up north. Great video. Definitely check it out. As usual, make sure you like and subscribe. NTR_WillSmith for my YouTube as well as my Instagram. NTR_WillSmith. And y'all stay safe. Don't touch people's hands because they don't wash their hands. I've seen people walk out the bathrooms and their hands were dry. Peace.
Pounders.
Oh, I'll never wash this flipper again.